Hi there, welcome back. This is the fourth video in the step-by-step series for Painter. And as I said in the last video, you need to close Painter periodically and open it back up so that it gets refreshed and stuff is saved. So I have closed it. I'm now opening Painter again. And once that is open, we will continue with our layout. Okay, so I've got the welcome screen up first. I'm going to go to New Document. I'm just going to put that same document up. And I'm going to, let's see, what do I want to do now? I want to continue with the layout. And so how would I do that? Well, like I said, I have specific ways of doing my layouts. And the first thing I would do is I would go to Windows, Palette Drawers, and I would start opening up Palette Drawers and see if how they're set up and whether they're the way I want them set up. And I can tell you that I want papers and I want flow maps to be in the same section. So I'm going to open up Papers. And it's right here. Drag it out here away from everything. And then I'm going to go to Windows and Palette Drawers, and I'm going to open up Flow Maps. And it popped down here. See, that's one of the things, is that these things pop out all over the place. And I want to organize that so they're popping out where I expect them to be. All right. I don't want this to be palette drawer anymore. I want them both to be in here. So if I want to take this out, I'm going to grab the gray area right to the right of flow maps, and I'm just going to drag it out like that. And what that does is it removed the palette drawer. So now I'm going to grab flow maps and I'm going to bring it up here. You see where the blue line is, it would add flow maps above papers right across, but I don't want to do that. I want to put it just to the right there. See that little blue line that's trying to go across right above my cursor? You can see a blue triangle. If I could bring it down a little more, let's see. There, you can see that when I let go, it's going to place that flow map next to papers, like that. Now, another thing I don't like is I don't want my grain here. For me, grain is more of a brush function rather than it is paper. So I'm going to drag grain off, like that. And then I'm going to come up here to rename, and I'm going to rename this papers/flow maps. Say enter. Then I'm going to move it over here to where it should pop up when everything is said and done. And we'll close that. And now grain. Where's grain going to go? Well, for some reason, I've always stuck it in opacity. And when I say opacity, oops, I'm in the wrong opacity. Let's click over here. That's something we'll have to talk about, the fact that there's much more with opacity in this new version. Anyway, I would open up this opacity flyout menu, and then I would click on the opacity panel and open it up. Now, the next thing I would do is I would grab the grain, and I'm going to add it to the bottom of that. Then I'm going to go palette drawer, rename, and we'll call it opacity/grain. And say OK. Now, where I want this to pop open is right here, right under the grain. Right under the opacity. So let's close it. So that means if I did this, it would always open up there. If I click on the opacity panel, it's going to open it right under this area. Okay, so we'll close that down. Now this is taking a while to do all of this, and I have mixed emotions over whether I want to do the whole thing and let you just witness the whole thing, and maybe that's what I should do. I don't know. We'll keep going for the moment. All right, so I've added now I've changed the palette drawers to paper and flow maps, which I like. Now, photo art, I'm going to click on photo art, bring that one up. Photo art is clones, clone color, clone method. Yeah, all of that is fine. I wanted it to be different, but it's fine. I'm just going to move it right over here and click it off so that's where it pops up next time. And we go to palette drawers again. And I want to go to patterns. Now, this is the one I want to add stuff to. So I'm going to go to Windows, palette drawers. We have weaves. I'm going to go to Windows, palette drawers, and we have gradients. Window, palette drawers. Da da da. I think I'm going to open up image hose. And we go back over here to palette drawers. And I don't need any of the other stuff quite yet. But I do need painter patterns, gradients. Let's go window, brush control panels, and no, that's not what I want. I want to go to media panels. All right, so paper and flow mats are taken care of. I need textures. I need window, media panels. I need looks. Okay. And I'm going to go, window, media panels. And I want to bring in, images and selections, and I hope they're on the same. Yeah, here it is right here. Yep, they're all together. Okay, so what I have right now is a series of things that I want to turn into palette drawers. So this is the first easy one because it's just already set up, and I'm going to rename it. It's set up as image / selection portfolio. And we say OK on that. Move it up here to the top. Click it off. All right. Now, patterns. I want to add weaves to patterns. So the first thing we would do is we would grab the weaves part, put it right there next to patterns. And then we would get the pattern weave libraries. Let's go back to pattern. We get the weaves libraries. Well, here we go. All right, so then we would take it and put it down at the bottom of the weaves so that if we clicked on weaves, we would have the weaves library below. Now, textures, let's come over here. Okay, so the same thing is going on here. I want to take the textures, and I'm going to add it to the right there. All right, so we have textures. Transform textures came into place, and we want to add... No, the textures library is there. So that added everything we needed to this. So we've got pattern sweeps, textures. Let's go back up here and look media panels. All right, I want some more stuff. I don't think I'm going to put the looks there. I mean, looks would normally go up here too. Actually, I am. So I'll go ahead and take this and put it up to the right of that. Gradients that I want to put there. And texture painting, that's going to be, that is a palette drawer. I'm going to put it right there. We'll close that down. The patterns, looks, and so forth, we're going to start on patterns, have it there. And why are my weave libraries down here? Okay, it's got it all there. It's not exactly the way I would have normally had it, but it's all there. So I wanted to open up with patterns, and we put it up here in the normal space and go click off. And at this point, we've been in the video for 11 minutes, and I don't want to go any further. So I'm going to stop here, but first I'm going to come up to Windows. I'm going to go to Layouts, and I'm going to Save Layout. And remember, it's called Skips 2023. We say OK. Yes, replace it. And now I can close Painter, which will, save the workspace and so forth. Okay, that's it for this video. I will be back in another video shortly. Bye-bye.